Okay, so my friend gave me a gift, and the gift was a Bose speaker. The speaker has a subwoofer and also two small speakers. The thing sounds really good, so I wanted to connect it to my TV. The problem is my TV does not have any digital output. So if you can see here, this is the controller for the Bose headphone. And the speaker has this 3 millimeter output. The problem is my TV has analog output of the audio, which is the optical output. So what we are going to learn is that how to connect any digital speaker to your TV, which only has a analog output like optical output or a coaxial output. All right, so for that you actually need extra device. Let's go into that device. Okay, so this is a DAC, which is a digital audio converter. So I bought this from Amazon. It's not that much. It's worth like $14 to $20. Let's open it and see what's inside this. We can have guarantee cards of some sorts. So okay, let's put it here. There's a user manual. All right, in this part we have a cable. I think this is going to be a micro USB power cable. We'll put it here. This is a coaxial input cable. And this is the optical input cable, which I need for my TV to output the audio. So if you can see here, there's a cap because this is an optical input device, so it has a protective cap on the tip of the cable. You need to put it out before you can use this. It's kind of sticky. Okay, all right, so now we need this. We're also going to need the power. For now, we don't need this, so just put that inside. Let's see what we have here. On this side, you have the DAC, so the digital audio converter. So this is a 192 kilohertz DAC, which is good enough for me for my TV. So if you see here in this side, you can see that we have power input. Then we also have this is a coaxial input, which goes for this one, and also you have the audio optical input, so that's for this one. On the other side, we have left and right. This is for direct output for your speaker, but we will use this 3 millimeter port that if you see here. This one from my Bose speaker. This is my controller for my Bose speaker, and this is the wire, and that goes right here. And on the other side, we will use this one. So let's first get this one out. All right, so now this actually will go to this one right here. So if you can see, it's called optical. So we'll just put this here. It will just click. Have to match the sides. There you go. So now this is ready. The other part of this optical cable has to go to my TV, which I'll show you right now, and then the whole system will be ready. Oh, I forgot. So we also need the power. So let's open up the power cable. And and this micro USB power cable. We have a power input on this side, and we'll just put this here, and there you go. This has to go to any power brick which have 5 volt output. I'll put it into a charger, and or you can put it, plug it in into your TV. If your TV has a USB output, it can also go there. Other than that, this system is ready. So let's put this part of the cable into the TV. All right, so let's move these things out. Let me show you once more that what the system looks like after plugging everything in. This will go to the TV. This will go to your power brick. On this side, this is the cable that goes to the speaker, and that's about it. Okay, so as I said, we need to power this DAC with this USB port. So I have here a USB input, which is 5 volt, 1 amp. You actually can use 2 amp, but don't use a 3 amp power output. So put it here, and then you can see that it has this red light which is shining here. So this indicates that the system is actually active. So now what we need to do is we need to put this into my TV, and then we're good to go. So after you connect everything, what you need to do is you need to go to your settings and find the audio's output and change it to the optical output. So when I do this, then this is how it sounds. Alright, I hope this video has been useful for you. If you like it, please click the like button and share it with your friends. I'm signing off. Until the next time.